The speed limit is 30 miles per hour, but try going 35 miles per hour over the tramp, said Brad Schreiber, one of the engineers who worked on the ride and handling of the new Chevrolet Colorado ZR2. He was traveling shotgun in his truck. The diesel engine roared, and seconds later there was silence in the cabin as we caught a few inches of air. Woo-hoo. That was fun. I said with a smile on my face as we landed softly. We were in a Baja-style closed course in Gateway, Colorado, about 60 miles southwest of Grand Junction. You might have not noticed, but in every ramp we've caught air, Schreiber said. Not only can the Colorado ZR2 jump, but it can also tackle difficult trails. Chevy used the advantage of having a mid-sized truck to create a model that could rock crawl, run through the desert, and still deliver a decent ride on paved roads. The fact that the ZR2 is narrower than a full-size truck gives it a better advantage in terms of maneuverability, but Chevy needed the capability of a suspension that could support jumping and rock crawling. That's when Multimatic came in. As a company that's known for using damper technology on high-performance cars, Multimatic developed its first application of off-road damping on the Colorado ZR2. Using its dynamic suspension's spool valve technology, which is also used on the Chevrolet Camaro Z/28, the ZR2 dampers were changed to provide more piston travel for off-road use. The positional-sensitive damper includes three operational ranges: off-road bump, on-road operating, and off-road rebound range. There are two spool valves that provide compression and rebound damping for regular driving, but the third spool is exclusively tuned to deliver a compression damping during intense off-roading. There's also a separate housing to increase the oil and nitrogen reservoir capacity, and everything was designed to enhance cooling. The result is a suspension that absorbs the weight and force well when landing after catching some air, while also providing a pleasant on-road driving experience and tackling some of the most extreme trails in the country.